All right, y'all, I'm waiting for the doctor, but let me tell y'all something. I just got weighed. I weighed 120, so I gained 2 pounds. I started my weight gain journey on the 8th, which was Sunday. So, 10 pounds away, guys. That's a good thing. All right, this door is open, so let me turn this off. Talk to y'all later. Bye. Hi, nice to meet you.
I know you've seen Dr. Taylor here before.
Yes.
I think she's just back from her maternity leave.
Mm-hmm.
So, when you were here with her, it was in last year.
Yes.
In March, a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, did the stuff that she gave you help at all?
It did help to lighten my chin, but now I'm experiencing these white blotches. I don't think it had anything to do with the cream that she gave me. She gave me Tazerac.
When she gave you the cream, you had only dark spots?
Yeah, I only had this big dark spot on my chin.
Mm.
When I first discovered what it was, I went to the allergist first. I didn't think to come here first. And he told me that it could be a fungal infection.
Okay.
So he gave me this cream here.
Last year?
Yeah, last year. Oh, this was last year.
Did that
year.
Make any difference?
It killed the fungus, but it left behind a dark bruise.
Okay.
So that's why I came here to the dermatologist. She gave me this.
And
but it was burning.
Bleach. She gave you a bleaching cream.
It was burning. I couldn't take it, so I just stopped altogether.
Okay.
But it did help to lighten it,
right.
But I didn't get my regular complexion back. So just recently, I started experiencing these white blotches on my chin, and my hair is thinning. And I also have this dark patch on my upper back. It's like I'm getting all these strange skin issues.
Okay.
I don't know what it is.
When did all these blotches start coming out?
A month ago. I had it for a month, and they never went away. They just sat there. So I was like, okay, let me go find out what's going on.
Okay. Let me see the patch on your back.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's it. And it stays very dry and itchy.
Yeah, it looks like it's itchy.
Yeah, it's very itchy.
Have you been using any acne medicines, anti-aging creams, any new moisturizers or facial cleansers?
Okay, this is what I did. I had used shea butter as a moisturizer, and that's when I started noticing the dry patches. So I stopped using that, and I switched to Dove soap. That didn't help. So it was like, I don't know what's going on. I don't know if there's something internal maybe or...
And when you say your hair is thinning.
Yeah.
Like, how sudden is that? Or is that something that's been kind of getting worse over the past few years?
It's been getting worse.
Okay. Anyone in your family have any skin issues or hair issues?
Nope, not to my knowledge, no.
Okay. And do you take any medications?
Just multivitamins, no medication.
When you said you never got your regular color back on your chin, what happened to it? What happened?
It's just stayed dark.
Stayed dark?
Yeah. It was light. It was much darker than this. The Tazerac was doing well, but I just couldn't tolerate the burning it was giving me. It was really bad. And it was starting to peel, so I was like, okay, I'm going to stop using this for a little while.
Now, do these patches on your face itch?
Yes.
Do you find yourself scratching at them?
I try not to, though.
What do you use to wash your body in the shower?
Dr. Bronner's liquid soap.
When did you
start organic
using
soap. I've been using it for a while. But I don't use it on my face. I just use it, like... on my body. For my face, I wash my face with Oil Volay moisturizing soap. And to me, that's been pretty good. It hasn't left my skin feeling stripped of moisture or nothing.
Is your hair loss getting worse and worse and worse, or is it just kind of thinner now for a couple of years than it used to be?
Yeah, it's thinner now, like right here in this area.
Yeah.
And also the back.
Yeah.
And it's in the same area. I experienced this before. I noticed it before, and they told me I had dermatitis. So they gave me some drops and my hair grew back in. But then years later, I'm getting the same issue. The itchiness, and then my hair, like, is literally falling out.
What kind of shampoo are you using?
I'm using a shampoo bar. It's like a shampoo in form of a bar. It's an organic soap. An organic shampoo.
Pardon me for writing while we're talking.
It's okay. It's okay.
Do you get your period regularly every month?
Yes.
Are you on the pill?
No.
Have you ever been on the pill?
Yes.
When did you go off it?
They put me on, I had a large fibroid last year, and I recently had it removed in October of last year. So they put me on a pill just to see if they can try to, you know, stop it from growing or, you know, for it to shrink. So it was a lot going on with that. So they finally gave me a myomectomy. And it was a success. But it's like after the fibroid went away, after they removed it, now I'm experiencing all this skin issues.
And you're still getting your period regularly?
Yes. Yeah, even when I had the fibroid, it would come out on time, but it was extremely heavy.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I get it on time every month, though. Now the bleeding is much better. It's cut in half, back to normal.
Okay. Does your head itch at all?
Yes.
Somebody be a little closer. And then look that way for me. I'm just looking in your ears.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm just going to look at your scalp.
Sure.
Okay, so one thing I want to just caution you about, just to be careful, mm-hmm. is that twisting the hair over years causes it to stop growing well. It pulls on the hair roots. And they get sore, and then they die. So certain hairstyles and hair styling can, over years, cause hair loss that's permanent. And I don't know if you've ever seen women whose hairline is like really far back.
Yes.
It's from perming and braiding and all that stuff. So just be very gentle, you know, with any style you have. There's no sensation of any pulling. Everything loose.
Okay. Yeah, I haven't twisted my hair in, it's been a while. It's been a few months. I just try not to mess with it.
Right, good, good. And when you use that soap to wash your hair, how often are you doing that?
Every 2 weeks.
Okay. I feel like there's a chance that this might be a mild form of a skin fungus.
Okay.
Which is really a form of facial dandruff.
Okay.
And it can make this itchy back here too. And then it goes along with small patches on the face, and it goes along with itchy hair that's thinning, which is what they treated you for before, that dermatitis they were talking about.
Right.
Seborrheic dermatitis. Mm-hmm. This might be that.
Okay.
If it's not that, it's one of two other things, which I don't think it is. One, vitiligo, which is where the skin loses its pigment and turns white.
That's what I thought it was.
I know.
I was a little
concerned. But that doesn't go along with this on the back of your neck. Right. And really, this looks like the areas are itchy.
Yeah, they're very itchy.
And real vitiligo mm-hmm. doesn't really have dark spots with it.
Okay.
So you have white and dark. Mm-hmm. So I don't think it's plain vitiligo, which doesn't itch, doesn't have dark spots with it, it just happens.
Okay.
So we're gonna just put that to the side.
Okay.
I don't think that's what it is. And the only other thing, which is what I would be more concerned about medically, is if it could be something related to a condition called lupus, which is skin lupus. And that's a condition where your body attacks itself. It can just attack the skin, which is not dangerous, but annoying. Mm-hmm. Or if it's real lupus inside your body, it can attack your organs and make you sick.
What?
I don't think this is that either, because normally your ears would have some changes and we would see some things on your scalp, and I don't see anything.
Okay.
And this is not in the classic spots for it.
Okay.
and it also usually isn't white. Right. It's more like purple or dark. Okay. So, these are the things in the back of my mind, which, if we can't fix this, we're going to look into. Okay. But I think it's patches of the seborrheic dermatitis, and then I think it's getting itchy back here, and because you're scratching and rubbing it a lot, that makes it turn dark and thick.
Right.
So I actually want to give you two different medicines. One is like the antifungal cream you got, but a little bit stronger. Okay. And that's for all of the patches front and back.
Okay.
And then another one is an anti-inflammatory cortisone cream that's going to help thin and flatten this and take away the itch.
Okay.
And then I want you to try to use a dandruff shampoo when you wash your hair.
Okay.
Because the medicated dandruff shampoos kill the organism that causes all of this.
Okay.
And if it's just living in your hair, it can kind of get onto your skin. And because you only wash your hair every 2 weeks, it has a lot of time to build up in between.
Okay.
So it can be harder to manage.
Right. So try like Selsun Blue or...
Yes. Okay. And you know, that can be a little bit drying for your hair. So you might need a little moisturizer or... oil, just to keep it not from getting too dried out by the medicated shampoo.
Okay.
But if you get the medicine on there and let it sit for a few minutes before you rinse it out, it can help reduce itching and kind of help the scalp calm down so that the hair will start to grow again.
Okay.
I'm actually going to give you three prescriptions. No, that thing doesn't exist anymore. Two prescriptions for now, and we'll see how we do.
Okay.
Okay.
Alright guys, I'm leaving the doctor's office. On my way home. Alright, so that was my footage from going to the dermatologist earlier. Okay, now I have a question for you guys. To those of you who suffer with this particular type of dermatitis, I'm going to put the name of it in somewhere in this video. It's called seborrheic dermatitis. Now, to those of you who suffer from that, I'm going to need your help, because now I'm going to have to up my washing routine. Should I do it every other day, or should I just do it once a week? I was thinking maybe once a week, just to reduce the stripping of my hair. So, for those of you who suffer with this particular condition, what is y'all hair washing routine like? Do y'all do it more frequently than before? Because I'm doing every 2 weeks right now, but judging by what she said in the footage, I'm gonna have to up it up maybe to once a week. So help a sister out. I appreciate it. All right, let me go get my other cream for my face, and I'll see y'all later. Bye.